World of Tanks is a free-to-play game that apparently has a world record, and that a bunch of people keep asking about. So, you either want to somehow increase performance on it, or you want to experience World of Tanks in a way you have never seen before. Good. Welcome to the LowSpecGamer, the show where I explore ways of reducing graphics in games by all ways possible. So, forget about regular texture sizes because we're making this game run. Huh, I had not said that in a while. Before moving on, ultra-lowering graphics might help you with FPS, but what if you're looking to have better network performance in your online game? I am glad to say this video is sponsored by Outfox, a service that allows you to connect to an optimized gaming network that provides better latency and stability, and you can try it for free in the link in the description. If you're playing a game that is on the compatibility list, like World of Tanks or Overwatch, you just let it open in the background and it will do its thing. Really easy. Hell, if it detects your normal network is faster than the private one, it will turn off automatically. Gotta appreciate its honesty. So, give it a try. I will be using it during the video. World of Tanks is a long-running free-to-play game. It runs on its own Big World engine, and if you want to get some extra performance on the current version, there are quite some things to do. Something interesting that you can start with is DirectX 9. By default, the game seems to run on DirectX 11, but you can easily force it to use an older version of DirectX using a launch command. To add a launch command, you can go to the installation directory of the game, which is usually on the game's folder, and add a shortcut of the main .exe of the game to the desktop. And in the properties of that shortcut, you can add this launch command, clientGraphicsAPI D3D9, which is also in the description. Now, every time you start the game through this shortcut, it will be using DirectX 9. Using the X9 adds an interesting perk. You can now use Hialgo tools to cut the resolution when you need an extra FPS boost on GPU bottlenecks. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, Hialgo is a set of tools to change the resolution of DirectX games while playing. I'll be using Hialgo Switch, a tool that cuts the resolution of the game in half at any moment with the press of a button. However, Hialgo does not seem to detect the game correctly. There's a sort of brute force fix for this that you can do by going into the Hialgo configuration file in the Documents, My Games, Hialgo, Switch or Boost, and then the folder with the name of the game. By setting this variable to false, the resolution of everything will be cut when you switch. In here, you can also have an opacity variable that you can set to 0 to remove this logo, or this variable to remove the FPS counter if you wish to do so. The default button to switch resolutions is the middle mouse button, and you can immediately notice the difference in visibility and performance every time I switch. A cooler thing you can do in this game is installing a texture resolution mod to reduce the size of the game's texture. I will be using this 6% resolution mod link in the description that works with version 9.19 of World of Tanks. This website is a good place to find other texture compression mods in general. Sadly, the install instructions on the mod page itself are wrong, so after hours of trying to read instructions in Russian, by the way, hello dear Russian viewers, thank you for watching, I understood how to install this. You need to move all the contents of the mod to the installation directory of the game in the game's folder, then res and finally packages. There are a bunch of numbered bat scripts in the new files that you need to run, from 1 to 8 to extrol all the textures of the game. This is like looking into the Matrix, but less cool. There will be a new folder, this one, with the scripts for the 6% resolution textures. You need to take everything inside this folder and move it back into the main package folder. Finally, you run this auto-install script that repacks the compressed textures so the game can use them. If you're doing this, you might want to get a drink or something, because this can take a while. But after it is done, you will notice that the game has severely dropped in quality. Take a look.
Welcome to the best combat game you have ever seen in your life. Isn't this amazing? Oh no, 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 turn. Is there anything I can do? Oh god. Now we're moving at a really slow pace, so this is not good. Oh, that's not good, that's not good, that's not good. That's terrible. That was absolutely terrible. Ah, seriously? Oh god. Did I kill him? I think I did. At the cost of two friendlies, but that's something, right?
Ha ha ha!
Things just disappear when you touch them. Oh god. It's funny, I was just complaining about how I'm a little bit tired of playing too many very fast games, but I seem to have gone the other spectrum, although I have no idea why in the world would I expect a tank game to be fast. I think this might actually be better. Oh, almost got him, mine. Oh god. I'm trying to take cover behind this rock, but I think... Oh yes, this. That was definitely a terrible idea. Come on. Come on! Seriously! That was so close. I'm getting proper into this. Okay, I see one. And this time I'm gonna get a little bit better about cover. Oh, okay. There's a medium tank right there, and I think we can take him. If we're careful, we can totally take him. Fire! Okay. Well, four against one wasn't exactly... Oh! Well, never mind. That wasn't that bad.
That is all for this video. Truth be told, I am currently taking a small break to be able to continue doing videos more effectively, and I feel like there are a lot of other tips to explore in this game. Do you know any? Do you want me to keep improving performance on this game further? Let me know in your comments. And thank you to those donating in Patreon, as always. Love you all.